So you think that I'm done? That my career will soon be over? You don't know me. All my life I had to fight. No one believed in me. So I had to believe in myself. Some people wanted to break me, but they only made me stronger. Others wanted to exploit me. They only made me smarter. And now you think I'm done? To all of you, I only have one thing to say. I'm not like you, because I'm not you. I am Zlatan Ibrahimović, and I am just warming up.
The Zlatan is both a fearsome predator, a bird of prey like a peregrine falcon, and also a stupendously glorious peacock, magnificent in its spectacular display of plumage. I think the only person who loves Ibrahimovic more than me is the man himself, but that's all right. His monumental talent eclipses his ego. His absolute genius with a football puts him in a category of utterly unique footballing artisans. Here was a footballing Caesar. Where comes such another? Not from England, I guarantee you that.
How do you think people that don't know you would describe you?
I think they would say that I'm very arrogant. That's what I hear all the time. Very cocky. He has a bad character, bad personality. But then when they meet me, they're like, that image doesn't fit you. That is what I say. You should never judge a person if you don't know him.
And Ibrahimovic, well, they are both exceptional players. Ibrahimovic is more of a creative talent.
Before Ibrahimovic came here, I thought he was a fantastic player. After getting to know him, I think he's even more fantastic. Seeing him at close quarters, you really realise how strong and powerful he is. He's a player who has won 6 or 8 league titles in 3 different countries. As a player, he's in a league of his own.
He wants to win, he wants to work, he wants to be the best. He has a big ego, big self-esteem. He knows that he's really a top player. So.
With that divine connection linking those eyes to his crystal ball within his brain, and then all the way down that magnificent 6'5" frame to those fabulous feet, he is a surgical maestro with the God-given talent, not coached or developed. He was touched. Like in that Michelangelo picture, the way all the football immortals are, the creation is good. Ibra produced the silverware everywhere, from Ajax to PSG and every one of the great clubs in between. But none of that does him justice in my book. His type of talent is more than special, than trophies, but he won them anyway. I talked about his undeniable self-love earlier. There's a great song called The Greatest Love of All. The George Benson version is the best. And it says everything. So give it a listen. It's magic. And it's what the truly great players like Zlatan have. This man was a unique giant of a footballer for me. The magnificent nose. Says he wanted a statue of himself to replace the Eiffel Tower. Where do I sign the petition? I'd crawl on broken glass to see him hang out his laundry. Ibra Kadabra!
Stars and mine, you and I, we're on.
I'm looking back and thinking where I came from, who would thought that the guy from Rosengård will do this kind of things? Who thought the guy from Rosengård will be captain of the Swedish national team? Who thought the guy from Rosengård will break the records of the goals through history? When I look back after I quit, I will think the story is pretty nice, pretty good.